qualifying, and there's rain. Yay! Drop that knowledge. We added a slight amount of downforce, which added oversteer. So we want to trend in the direction of under, I guess, and see what that leads us to. Inners. Same thing here. Inners. Basically, we just want to try to get on the board with both drivers. Yeah, this is gonna be a dumpster fire. This track kind of upsets the balance of everything. Back in before. How do we manage this? God dang. I'm like uncertain. We're not going to use more than one inner. I am not about that life. Poisu actually overheats the tires. Drinking strawberry water too close to brushing my teeth. The results of that are not pretty. Oh, there's not really going to be a gap. Might be a brief something. I think we're going to go strictly for we're just going to try to get dry tires out here. And then from here on out, I think the conditions are just too bad. One thing I will say is that no one was good here last season. We kinda sorta had something figured out, but I don't really intend to run again. Just trying to figure. You know, just figure anything about this out. Yeah, we're just messing around trying to, you know, just kind of sort of trying to hit 99. Not really succeeding. Not much, just looking for that 1%. And the game just stubbornly doesn't want to give it. Let's test it. This is kind of our final chance. And we're gonna be 1-2. I think that just stems from stems from us being the only one that really got a dry lap in. More than anything else. Sometimes the car does get kind of stubborn as far as hitting that 99% mark. We're kind of even keeling. Okay, we did. We got there. Eventually we got there. 87 laps, so we can put a lot of fuel in. Put an hour's worth in. We'll start with Etta. Problems. Problems. Yeah, the driver we start with is gonna matter. The smoothness doesn't make a huge difference, but it does make a little bit of one. Because with the smoothness, we can be out there a few minutes longer. Nickel rain! Yeah, it goes in, all in on soft tires. So we're the only ones running. We are the only medium tire runners. Fascinating. One of the things that I want to do if I continue playing this career mode is modify this track. Although maybe it's generally viewed as a positive. Now you can see the soft tires just not work. I mean, they work, but look at the pace. And look at the rate of wear, I mean, Jesus. The general idea here is to just reach the rain period. I'm not sure how cleanly we're going to be able to do that. Oh, Laura's a rain master. It would have been beneficial to have her out here, but we also need her smoothness to get us there. Jan's daughter's wear is essentially the same. I should have just used her. That's my bad. Mia battle. We may have unnecessarily backfooted ourselves. Although I feel like the AI is the one that's done that. Where we are, we should make the rain period. I don't think any of the softs will. We need to give our pace a little bit of a lift. This is the area where we're going to kind of start pushing the win button. These mediums just do a better job, like, durability-wise. I really do think they're the sweet spot tire for speed and durability. Oh, there we are. Only the holdouts are still out there. This is the part that just perplexes me, really. Do they just not have as good of a forecasting center as we do? Or like, what's the deal? I just have no idea what would possess the AI to start the race like that. Here we go. We've got till 5%. How long are the tires going to be good for the inner? Not very long at all. When they designed this track, I don't think they thought through the wet tires very well. I'll be running the rain tires down to the Nubians too. Pretty much losing our time advantage. Yeah, we're just kind of forced to we're forced to switch now, essentially. It'll be an early switch, but was more or less put off as long as we possibly could. Yeah, it actually gets a bit stubborn. We could come out of this looking pretty rosy. Oh, come on. Without the mistake, it would have worked. Nothing we could do there, unfortunate. And with these, we just run the tires until they're pretty much completely dead. Unless the conditions will change for us, which I doubt. Oh, Benitez comes out right in front of us. Excuse me. She's conserving. Which, with the temperatures these things are running at, that's not gonna work. That's just not happening. Another 35 laps, maybe. I think we might be able to close this disadvantage we're at to an extent. Basically, we just run as long as humanly possible, pit, run as long as humanly possible, pit, repeat. Benitez is still preserving. So that is essentially what we are dealing with. Yeah, we need to pull the trigger on Fawcett first. This track is its own kind of challenge for sure. We had a 20% disadvantage and now we don't. We don't seem to have that anymore. Benitez is no longer preserving. I'm fighting the move. I'm just trying to make it difficult for them. Don't use it all. Yeah, we are squabbling a bit. The old squabbler. So they'll be pitting a lap apart. I think we're just giving up the ghost on track position, though. Especially when the AI does that. And we'll monitor faucet now. How many laps have we actually done? Faucet 41. We put that much in, probably. So whatever the fuel says, minus. Whatever the tires say, minus 5 laps. 35. What's the future looking like? Yeah, we're not going to cross over. And then whatever Jan's daughter actually runs, we'll need to subtract. Hughes will probably run one fewer, Houghton. We'll put 37 in. This is actually one of the areas the AI is weak. Except Benitez is actively preserving. I'm pretty sure we can run inners down to zero. We're just being a little safe. Being a bit on the safe side. Just about a lap down. Gotta slink by the slow pokes. This is where things are going to get a bit fun. Because I think the AI does not take care of tires as well as we do. Like, watch Makarova just chew into these things. And we're just gobbing out on Benitez now. Alright. We need to get some heat into these tires. And this is the downside to running this race so late in the year. Tire cooling is a problem. Do we actually... Will we get ahead of Benitez? I'm curious. So we're gonna, like, check out the overlay. Whew, barely. Hanwin does say fluff tire preservation. Which is good because we're 20% behind them. Probably within the next stint, you're gonna see things look better for us. Leave it on and let's buy traffic. We got to be a bit careful about overdoing it. Comparison to Makarova. We're 8% behind. Macro of his pace after the fired up period ends, I think, is going to be key. You're looking pretty fast right now, though. Have to keep their dirty tricks off the board too. Vroom. Thank you. It's hard to think far enough ahead to the end of this rain period. We're gonna have to start thinking about that. Yeah, Makarova is just a little bit quicker. Our consistency has just been way better, like over the course of the season. Yeah, we're 12% behind. Yeah, what's actually going to happen is they're going to churn up their, they're going to start churning up their cars, and, give Vanderstead 35 laps, I think. We can give Boisue 37. Yeah, now they're going to throw away tire life. Going in at 5% is more of my own personal guideline. You can run these suckers all the way down if you want. .38 for Boisue. Not going to matter too much. Heaton falls to third, which is kind of annoying. Was actually trying to keep that tire alive. And we've crossed pit lane. We're gonna call in Laura, which is gonna be like 38 laps of fuel, and go. I was speeding up this lap because we ran an extended period of time at regular pace. The rain is going to stop. However, we're going to have some real issues here. It's gonna take a while before the track actually does dry out. Okay, we leapfrog Jones. He's putting us all into trying to be ahead now. Wet weather pro, so we get a boost for her driving in the rain. It's gonna be this game. This little game of back and forth. Seeing the end. It's going to require using pretty much all of our intermediate tires though. And even with this period ending, I would say that we're better off saving our fresh set. So we should use our used set to see this through, probably. Just get it done. And then restore the lead to what it was. And I think what we're going to do next, we're gonna fuel the car so we don't have to fuel it between the inner and dry period that's coming up. Man, Laura's looking really strong. Zhao might be their weakest driver from the looks of it. Yeah, now we just need a good foundation and we just need to like hope that we can like lead. Leaning really hard into the engine. We're third, but really, I think it's literally a couple of points between all the teams, like the top three. Engine performance is not a big thing at all, like, not a big difference. Who and Jones are squabbling. Alright, here we go. Let's fly. It is going to be a little bit. I think we use one of these sets significantly more than the other. Maybe we do go to a fresh set, I don't know. We have pulled out a lead. That part's really, really exciting. It's going to be fascinating. Probably should use another fresh set, actually. So that looks like it's about 45 minutes in before we... we'll even be able to think about dry tires. just hard to know what's going on. Like, this race is really, really bizarre. Now we're just pulling away. All right, faucet. Yeah, we'll just keep. Components look good. There we go. Yeah, it's hard to really know where we're supposed to. Where we're really supposed to be. I think we're going by twice more. And 38 laps, I think, is our ideal point. Oh man, this gets really serious now. We're overtaken by Pamplona. He does get out first. Weird. So it's weird to see when the AI takes this approach. Giselle left the car out way too long. Okay. Edward is quite a way back there, actually. And they're on used inners. So everyone's running out. And Hamlin's leaning hard into those tires. And I'm just thinking about what to do next. I don't really know. Very uncertain. I can burst off here too. Well, sort of. It kind of clanged. Weird. Navarro is fired up. That's not great for us. I would have had to bounce off Jan's daughter to get her fired up. Switch and then like switch back to her. I don't really care to tap drivers like that though. Not get stuck on the cars like that. Well, we have a bit of a storm to weather here. One of the Kanderstags just crashed. Caleb Gordon. I think Kanderstag number two, that is. Keep it in reserve. It's 2 minutes up the road, so it's gonna be very difficult. We might be in range to make up a 2 second difference now, though. Almost. He's fired up, so that's going to make it very tough. Okay. This tomfoolery is not helping. We've got our first dry tire out there now. Now we just have to compare times. We did about 50 laps. I screwed this up. I didn't. Didn't do this the way I wanted to. Have to go like this. I think we're at about the point where the dries are going to be faster too. Do we keep her in? I'm just kind of unsure of myself right now. Oh, come on. Two refueling mistakes in the same race. That's just, like, really stupid. Starting with Amber Houghton, so we need to just okay. I'll be right back. My facial hair some love here. Oh, the facial hair cut off. Oh, very itchy. We just need to make this pass. know what's left. Nobody's run hard tires in this race. This thing's so weird. It's playing out so weirdly. Not even remotely how I would expect it to. If it stays dry the rest of the way, we have a fascinating one on our hands. Because the real question from here is, like, literally, what's next? Okay. We're chasing this a little bit. Get 45 out of each driver. Just thinking about this in terms of like what the best approach is. Pamplona's struggling. Pamplona's failures are the main reason I think we've won this Constructors. They've given up a lot of points. As a team, they're very strong. Shinzu has the strongest driver of the four cars. Their second car just tends to be really, really weak. Sorry, just when it comes down to it. Alright, we can run another straightaway. We can't match the pace of Socks. We just need to try our darndest too, because it bears out long term. Boisu, I think, will barely be able to do 45 minutes, and then we can... I don't know. I was thinking, like, within team, like, what our best, what our best finishing looks like. And both those drivers are pitting. Oh, we're just stuck underneath that. That wasn't good. Boisu has 49 minutes. That's actually somewhat problematic. I think the move is to go Laura and then back to Houghton. Just gives us the best average time. Then also conversely from Boisu back to Vanderstead. Restoring stamina is like the trickiest part. My main worry from this point is time. Boisu's time, specifically. Okay. Tires are supposed to last like 60. We'll do this because Moisu doesn't. He has 49 minutes available. Laura actually has a little bit less. So we're actually being a little bit more careful. The owners, Laura, have 47 minutes. Wow. Third refueling mistake. It's a lot of refueling mistakes. Let's not risk it. We risk 5 seconds. I just don't want to overrun. And, you know, leave us vulnerable at the end. At the end of the stint. We should be okay on both fronts here. Where we don't put in is time that we will get to throw in a little bit later. Oh, that was a mistake of some. Yeah, she ran wide officially. That's why we don't generally run on the red if we unless we're just trying to close the gap. I will be right back.
Oh yeah, we're just cutting in.
We're actually in a race with who, so we have to be a little bit careful there. We also have to watch these numbers. Yeah, we're just gobbing this time out now. Just like, yes, just eat into it. Right, 31 laps in. I think they're gonna have problems finishing the race. I think they're gonna have massive problems finishing the race. Yeah, what I'm finding is that I actually like burning my battery on the straightaways. We're actively racing who? I'm not too worried about that. Not too worried about the way that's actually turning out. We just need to be mindful because these guys, there's not a lot between us here. So we just need to be ready to, and mostly just need to make sure we're out here long enough for Hewton to cover the end. Probably like somewhere around 70 points. We're just gobbing into Jones. I love it. Think they're gonna have problems finishing with the whatever tire they put on next. If the game really loves me, they're gonna try like fitting hards. Because that just simply won't work. It's looking like this till the end now. Don't waste it. Now he's burning. Finishing with Vanderstedt is going to be tricky. Vanderstedt on the mediums specifically is going to be Then just pitted and put on the hard tire. And my main opinion about this tire is it just doesn't work. It's just not fast enough. So that's where we're at. Is he trying to window in a hard tire? A hard tire stint. We're about to find out. I think even trying to run these above 50 minutes is going to be a problem. But they're also going hard. Oh man. Oh man. This is nuts. I think we have to put Vanderstad on the hards because I don't think we're actually challenging up front here, and I don't actually want us to run out of tire. We're in a very, very kind of uncomfortable zone. What'd she get, 46? Yeah, that's not... We're not gonna reach that. We need to be time-wise. Go to 51 minutes. Yeah, we just, car two isn't, maybe for six we're competing, but we're not anywhere close to these guys. Hutton 46, that is possible. Yeah, we're just going to... We're going to get Laura as close to max as we can. Is it like a minute each lap? 23 is probably as far as I dare go. Which is like right here. I just need to... I just need to take my time to make sure that we... I need to use all this time basically to ensure that Hutton can finish. And Hughes' consideration is not a time consideration. It's just a tire wear consideration. We're basically just feeling over the time that's left now. Navarro. Massive tire advantage. She's going to go by us. And you can see the hard runners just aren't competitive. And Navarro's problem is going to be simply finishing the race. We're in a little bit of danger while Dang is fired up, but I think it's going to work out for us. We're slowly gaining. Get him to about the same place, and we'll just turn the fuel up. We got good time on Schober. See how that works out. Dang is no longer fired up. That's the issue IMO. They just don't. Cars just aren't fast. They have no speed. It's basically like when you're trying to run the mediums against the softs. But the durability of the tires aren't that different. The softs wonk out in such a way that the durability is an issue. Turn this corner and give us some mother fluffin' straight line speed. This is my main thing here, is that we were never challenging fourth, mediums or hards, with car two. It's just not happening. Now I think what we need to do is hopefully we can just pull in. No longer fired up. So we should, from a theoretical standpoint, be able to pull in. Laura actually did take us over time by 5 seconds. I think you have to actually complete a lap over time, though, to get penalized. You get penalized, I think, for every lap after you're over time. So pitting while you're under time, I think, technically leaves you safe. Navarro is just absolutely just destroying this car right now. Alright, we're just maintaining the gap, which I think is all we really need to do. And yeah, you can kind of see, like, the durability is actually not that much better on these cars with the hard tires. The one thing I am annoyed about is that Navarro is just selling out his engine. It's just annoying me. We don't really need to do much. We just need to stay close. I'm pretty sure this car cannot finish on those tires. Another 20 laps. I think that's just impossible. Impossible. Then Adang's trying to pull up now. We just need to lean a little bit more into these tires. Give us a little bit more engine power. The only reason I'm really running hard on car 2 now is just to keep the heat in. Car 1 to maintain. Panwin fixing. I have to go around a lap to actually capture that position. That's good enough. That is more than good enough. Let's relax. Dang pits. Just. Yeah, they're not on the same lap. Should be safe. That should pretty much lock everything up. They only needed 3 for the constructors. And then the drivers, I think that was locked up, but now is like for sure locked up. For shizzle. for Shizzle locked up. Navarro can try to catch us, but I don't think he's making up 30 seconds in 10 minutes. And if Schober stops, like, that's just it. Like, she's done. Yep, we're all good. Hanwin, if we could finish ahead of, would be nice, but I don't expect it. Like, I don't actually expect it to happen. So us finishing above expectation there would just be wonderful. We do have a little extra battery. Yes. Just get it across the line. Well-earned win. Got the strategery. On this occasion, we at least knew what to expect. And that made it preparation, like everything here this time. With Dubai, We don't know what's coming. Yeah, it's over. Yay! One more race to go. Yeah, they're basically not developing. They might as well not be. Jeez. That was 16 here, and okay, we do have a fresh 17. Good. 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 Nose is finito. Yeah, we're done designing for the year. I would normally take more, but we come back to this quicker if we take that one. All right. We need more time with the brakes. I don't think any of this stuff will actually be ready for the next race. So it's just about getting points on. Brakes, rear wing. Actually, this rear wing will be better now. So that's good. And the rest of this is just, I don't know. Maybe we care about getting the brakes ready? Three, four, five, six, seven. Yeah. And then we just dump into this. Like that, and just take a little bit more improvement, be happy. No. Engine. Contracts running down. Okay. That is going to finish it for today, guys. We will finish off the season at a completely unknown track at some time in the near future. I assume it's going to take like 2 minutes to run this track. It's going to be like a 30 lap run, but don't know what it's going to be like. But yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Hope you enjoyed. If you haven't already done so, feel free to follow button one time. Sub, like, and share on the YouTube end if you're there, and we'll see you guys again next time. Till then, later on.